How y'all doing? Oh, good. Oh, I have someone I want to bring up. I see her here. Danelle Delgado. Let me see what's going on with this girl. Danelle is such a good friend of mine. She speaks at 10X Ladies. Hey! Danelle! Hello!
Hi!
I'm building empires over here. What are you doing?
I'm building my empire in Mexico today.
You're all over the place. You're like me, woman.
I know. Oh, I think we just high five in the air.
Yes.
This morning before I left, I had a whole bunch of people in my house. I had cleaners there and all these people. And on my coffee table was the Success magazine to which you are gracing the cover. And three of them walked by and they said, "We must know who this is. This is the most beautiful woman." And I go, "Wait till you meet her. It's even better if you could imagine." But it's quite the topic of conversation at my house. I don't think I'm ever gonna move it. I'm gonna leave it there and just keep reading.
Oh, I love you forever and ever. Thank you.
Congratulations. Nobody deserves it more.
Thank you. Very special honor. People are sending me text messages and DMs and they're Instagramming because they see it in the airports.
Yes.
Isn't that amazing?
It's so everywhere. Cool. It's so everywhere. Cool. It came in my mailbox, but it also is everywhere I go. It's pretty cool.
I love it. I'm super happy about that. Hey, you know what? I wanted to talk about building empires tonight. Really quickly before, because I want to ask you some questions, because you're someone who, you know, you've come from nothing, single mother, battled cancer, now you're a multi-millionaire, so you're definitely somebody I want to talk to and ask about building empires. But I want to pin this link real quick before I forget, because today is the last day, talking about building an empire.
Yes.
Today is the last day. I have Build an Empire online course, Danelle. It's 75 segments of video segments that you can go through on your own pace about building, expanding, protecting an empire, everything that you kind of need to know about that. And it's I did it for 4th of July. I extended it until today. Today's the last day, but it's only 270. Normally it's 1,997. So let me pin the link.
Yes. Oh my gosh. Do it. Cause I'm going to send it to all of my groups and all of my masterminds. If they haven't done it yet, are you kidding?
Oh man. I wish I would have told you earlier.
No, it's great. They'll do it right now. They'll do it right now. Yes.
I'm pinning it. Let me see if I can pin it. Yeah. Okay. So now I did that. I can focus. Okay, you know what, Danelle? I know this has happened to us from time to time. And I think, you know, for the most part, I have such incredible, I know you do too. I know you have such incredible people around you and in your life, but every once in a while, do you kind of get a little sucker punch where somebody kind of lets you down a little bit? And if so, how do you deal with that? Is it too windy where I'm at?
No, you're great. I hear you. It looks beautiful. I was going to sit out on my porch too, so you guys could all see the ocean, but it's super windy out there. Yours is much better. No. I think, you know what's funny is I think, look at it, it's so beautiful.
Isn't it beautiful? I'm going on my trampoline. You know, I have this trampoline. It's actually for the kids, but I've had one my whole life because I'm so hyperactive. Look, I love it.
It's like sitting on the ball.
But I won't do that. I won't do that while we're talking. I'm going to actually behave myself.
But okay,
I want to know how you handle yourself when it comes to getting a little low blow where somebody kind of lets you down a little bit.
Yeah. You know, I think, you know, it's interesting. The higher you grow, the more incredible people you attract, right? Then you have incredible people in your life. And I think what we have to, you know, everyone is human, right?
Yeah, I
know I've let people down in the past, and I know that I work really hard, right? I work really hard to not, but sometimes you have to know that everybody responds based on the level of their growth, right? So the goal, I always say, when things are going bad, go do something good. because there's nothing you can do like reacting to someone, fighting with someone, and not getting to the root of things. Like none of that is ever going to help look for what the real stuff is. So if you do stuff in a hurry, I try when somebody sucker punches to not be in a hurry and to go do something good, because then I come back to the situation with good in my soul. And if it needs to, you know, if you can do something, fix it. If you can't, fix you. And, you know, that's kind of all you can do. There's never going to be a day where you go on the rise and somebody doesn't sucker punch you once in a while, or you don't let someone down. There's no perspective.
Sure. Yeah. Oh, I know.
Just try to keep the train moving in the goodness energy, because I think energy is everything, right? I think I've been sucker punched so many times, and a lot of times I call you, I talk to you, and I'm like, show me how to handle this correctly as a good human. But I think even more importantly, all we have to do is watch your lead. That's part of build an empire. If you want to build an empire and you don't learn how to protect it like you did in those trainings, like you taught that, you taught me so many times on repeat, it's the weakest lesson probably in my body, because I want to help everyone, and then you can't save everyone, right? But if you don't learn how to protect this and the walk that you take and the team, if you don't know how to trust your own instincts, the sucker punches don't stop, right?
Yeah. And you know, a lot of people don't know how to communicate. You know, they'll just kind of misinterpret it or make it mean something else. I find now I'm just confronting things head on. I'm just kind of addressing it as it comes up, and in the most, you know, affinity, in terms of in the best way that I can, without like having an upset, trying to understand and clarify, and then just, you know, coming up with agreements that we can agree on. So that, like, there's no confusion about how I'm supposed to be, how they're supposed to be, that's left open for interpretation, which then allows you sometimes to get set up for that punch. But the other person, like, I know a lot of times I've let people down. I had somebody come to me today and was like, it's just not what I thought. I thought I was going to do this. And I said, wait, did I make agreements to you that I didn't keep? No, we didn't have agreements. Wait, so you mean to tell me you have this whole thing in your head that existed that you didn't tell me about, and then I let you down because I didn't help you fulfill that mission? You know, it's just, it's interesting.
What a great question. That's a brilliant question to ask, right? Did I make agreements with you? Did I miss something, right? Because then you learn if it's an emotion or a fact, right? A feeling or fact.
Because I got to know, did I take responsibility for something? Because, you know, I'm a pretty perceptive person, and I can sense things and feel things very easily, but I'm not a mind reader. Like, if you don't actually communicate, part of the communication cycle, which is so vital, is like when you have an idea, an intention, right? You have to have the attention. Like right now, I have to have your attention to be willing to hear what I'm saying. Now, I have to get this intention from my head. It has to cross this distance, in this case, through this phone. It has to go to you. You have to actually understand and duplicate what I'm saying, and then follow it by an acknowledgement so I understand that you got
That's
the communication.
Great.
If the communication never travels the distance and makes it to my side with duplication, don't think the communication occurred. It did not occur.
Right. It's so true. It's so true. I think half the battle is most people, when they're trying to communicate, all they really are trying to do is get their point across.
Yes!
Ever hearing, listening for what it is, asking questions to make sure it's clear, and addressing things in right. People, and especially, like, don't you think since 2020, heightened reactions are the norm, right? People are reactionary, they're moving so quickly, and they forgot how to fact things, right? That's actually how our brains work. First they feel, then they fact. We have to teach it how to fact, you know? But it's one of the greatest lessons of our time. I always say, well, when you get it wrong, you learn so much more about how to do it right the next time.
Yeah, 1,000,000%.
And if you study it, I do think you have to study it. You must study, right?
I study all the time.
Yeah.
I study all the time.
Yeah. I ask you all the time where to study. You give me time. I'm studying all over the place right now, and I'm loving it.
Do you know what I did on the plane ride? And I study everyone.
Yeah.
I mean, no, I don't study everyone. I'm actually very, I don't know why I say that. I'm saying I'm willing to study anyone because I'm telling you that I even study Grant Cardone because yeah. on the way home on the plane, I re-listened to him talk about the Millionaire booklet.
Yes.
And like, I listened to his content. And it was, it's, and a reason I say that is because you would think, oh, that's kind of bizarre. You're his wife. Why would you listen to his content? I re-listened to it because it's good content. But my point to all of that is I'm always learning. I'm always trying to educate myself. I'm famous for looking up words. I love looking up words, you know?
Mm-hmm. Well, you're the one who told me when you're reading something or you hear something and you get to a word you don't understand, you actually can't listen to the rest of it. And ever since you told me that, every book I have read, every conversation I've had, I've stopped people and said, hold on, I want to understand the rest. So let me just clarify what that means. I want to make sure I have the correct understanding. That has changed so much of my last 2 months, actually.
Wow. It's so powerful because, you know, until you have full conceptual understanding of the topic that you're studying, you can't fully be able to apply because you can't see the whole picture. So you can't like really fully apply yourself in that area. So I'm glad that you're doing that, especially, you know, what's disheartening about these kids is in school, they're not taught to look up words. So when they go past all these words and then the page goes blank and they go into non-comprehension, right?
Right.
Even if it's a word they think they understood, like I'll give you an example,
right.
A mistress. Okay. I came across something in a book, a mistress. And all of a sudden, the rest of it didn't make sense to me because I'm like thinking of a mistress being someone that you have an affair with.
Right.
So the rest of it didn't make sense. I get bored with the book. I want to put it down. I don't understand it. Like,
yeah.
I think something's wrong with me. You know, you get labeled, oh, you got ADHD. You can't understand. And I know that policy, right? Never go past a word you don't understand. So I went back and I looked at the word mistress because I was like, it just doesn't make sense here. I looked up the word and sure enough, there is a definition of that word mistress, which is a woman who is the mistress of a circus who like guides the animals.
Oh.
And that was the application of the word mistress in that particular context. And once I read it, I finished understanding the whole thing and I was like, wow, that was really cool. But it can happen with words that you think you already know.
Right. Well, it's like, it's almost like school teaches our kids and taught us how to just blur the lines past everything, right? Like if you don't understand something, read the context around it, figure it out and move on. And that's
what they told my daughter Scarlett. That's what they told my daughter Scarlett. And she, you know, then the kids are coming home and then they think something's wrong with them because they're not understanding and they're not getting things. It's that's why I got my kids out of the school system.
Yeah.
You know, I'm like, no, our kids, you're gonna be able to have access to knowledge. You know, they say knowledge is power, right?
Yeah. I laughed yesterday. Bella, my daughter, shared on her stories. I didn't even know we were moving some stuff around at the house, and she shares a post of three books from my office and says, "When you borrow mom's personal development books from her office." Right. And she took a picture of it and shared it. And she was excited to read these three intense books from my collection, shared it. Tonight, I had a message from a woman going, "That's your daughter? I haven't read those books. I'm going to go buy them right now." And I'm like, if we only taught, like they learned from us. She has seen me pour myself into books and reading and learning and studying and dictionaries. And so she picked it up and taught adults today. Like, why wouldn't they just go pick up personal development book? She was like, I've never thought about that.
Not awesome.
Right? So cool. So I screenshotted it. I sent it to Bella and I go, hey, you're teaching adults in my feed. Way to go, buddy.
Oh, wait, total non sequitur because we've had this conversation and then I don't want to, you know, take up too much of your time here.
No.
But because we had this conversation previously, you're never going to believe what my office and I decided. You know, after we had our conversation about I was actually thinking, I'll just let everybody know the secrets behind the scenes. I was talking to Danelle. I was like, you know, do I want to just focus on Empire? You know, by the way, for those of you that don't know, I do these four build an Empire Mastermind. The next one's coming up in August 19th and 20th, by the way.
Yes, you have to go. It's the best thing I've ever done.
Well, I do 4 a year. One's on mindset. Yes. One's on health, wellness, lifestyle. It's called Design Your Life, right? One's the next one that's coming up in August is money. It's Create Your Wealth.
Yes. I'm doing
Create Your Wealth, so I'm writing the workbook right now. And the last one's on relationships. So anyway, I was talking to Danelle, and I was saying, you know, do I really just want to focus on this empire thing? 10X ladies, I love my 10X ladies, but that's like more growth con driven. It's, you know, where I have Danelle, I have multiple, I have to be totally clear and honest. I have the women in my life that I either want to be in business with or I am in business with, to let you have the inside of how I run things, how the women around me are powerhouse women. Anyway, so we thought, I was like, you know what? I might end up scratching 10X ladies and just doing an Empire event. So the people at Empire aren't confused about it just being a ladies event. Well, right as I'm deciding, okay, this is what I'm doing, the office and I and you know, everyone's involved, all the execs, and they're like, we're going to get behind 10X ladies. I'm like, wait, what? They're like, we're going to get behind 10X ladies on a massive scale. We want you to do 10X ladies.
Yes.
We want it to be a big event with a, you know, a ticket that's a more, like a moderate price. Because I did 10X ladies, the Power Players edition. It was a $10,000 ticket. It was on the ship. Right. It was full. It was sold out. It was epic. But I could only have 200 ladies.
Right.
But this one, they want to do a couple thousand person event, have the tickets at like $299 or something like that, make it really accessible so we can have women, you know, empowering women, supporting women, and getting applicable data to go home and change, you know, be able to have their pillars and mindset.
Yes.
The four pillars of being 10X, mindset, relationships, money, and health and wellness. So,
yeah. You know, oh, my gosh. I'm so in. I can't wait to share it and get everyone I know there. I'm telling you, like, for everybody listening who's sharing this out, who's tagging their friends, which you should be doing, okay, when you study with as many people as possible most of your life, I've spent almost 2 decades learning, studying, trying, and I will tell you, there has never been greater truth, integrity that backed it up, and true relationships than working with Elena, with doing anything 10X. It's the most in tune I have ever felt. Even going all around the world, I had all these messages the last time I was at, I went to the Lifestyle Mastermind and was there. And I think sometimes we work so hard, we forget that we also need to train, right? I wrote for 3 days after that. My mind was blown. I had all these thoughts and it really shifted so much in my life. And I think if the higher you get, the harder it is to find people who inspire you, who tell you the truth, will be there like they said they were going to be there. And I just, like, anytime you ask, Elena, I'm in, I will share it with my husband. Very hard to find days with so many people as experts in the world, but any ticket I'm buying, I'm in. My whole audience will be. This is a movement I would get behind with my kids, my life. These pillars that you create, these different facets that you take on life, they have really been the scaled trajectory that I longed for my whole life. I could figure out on your own. Hard work only does so much. Right? So you have to get to the skills and the environment and the community. Because if we have like 3 of them and not the last one, everything's off kilter. It doesn't matter. They're all attached.
You can't be 10X in your finances and have your relationships. You can't be 10X in your health and have your finances down the tube.
Yep.
It's got to be 10X on all 4 pillars. So I'm definitely bringing back 10X ladies for next year. Because we already did our event this year, but it's going to be big and it's going to be bad and it's going to be amazing.
I can't wait. I'm in. This is exciting and they're way behind it. Let's do it big.
I know. The office is like, how dare you think of not doing this? By the way, after the last Design Your Life event, my wheels, I went like up another notch. I'm like, okay. you know, if we're going to design and we've already done big, I got to go bigger. Now we got to go all in. Like, now we have to show and pour on that when you hit a level, you can go deeper and hit another level. Yeah. And that's, you know, I can't wait to tell you, so many amazing things have happened since then.
I can't wait. I know we have a lot to catch up on. A lot.
I know.
It's shifted everywhere for everyone. I haven't talked to anyone who was there that isn't like complete shifts, complete transition. Like it was so solid. And I've been to every training probably there's ever been created. It was so solid.
It was solid, right?
So solid. I have goosebumps right now thinking about it. That's weird. And that's cool. It's, you know, I think when people their whole life hunger and they work so hard and they're like, is it me? Is something wrong? Is it what? And I'm like, it's the wrong information. If you, right? It's the formation of everything. This is what Elena.
Information means the origin of that word means formation of the mind.
Yes. I am telling you, I think the majority of us are raised not on purpose, just by way of default, with so much of the wrong information that we trust. And when you find yourself in a room with the right information, that's the rocket ship you're looking for. And that's what you are to me. I'm so grateful. Woo!
The thing about that word is, you know, information is the formation of the mind, you know, and with the wrong information, you have a deformation of the mind. So I used to think something was wrong with me. Like, what's wrong with me? Until I realized that definition of the word information, I'm like, no, I just have a deformation of the mind. I have some wrong piece of data, some false data. You strip away false data and you're left with truth. And that's power. That is knowledge. They say knowledge is power. You know, what is it if you have the wrong information? The complete opposite.
Right. Destruction. How many times I've done that?
You right? know? And I think a lot of us were indoctrinated with the wrong information for a reason. I mean, I don't think we're supposed to be like, you know, I think there's an active interest in the non-success of certain people, certain groups, certain brackets, you know, whether it's financial, culturally, whatever, all of them, lump it all in. There is a suppression out there on people to not know. Because when they don't know, guess what?
Right.
You can pull the wool over their eyes. You can sell them a bill of goods. You can tell them whatever.
I'm so grateful. Like, if you look at, circling back to how we started this call, right? All of us are going to get kicked in the, oh, my son's on. He's here saying hi. Hey, buddy. At the beginning of like when life kicks you or somebody kicks you or stabs you or hurts you, I have never once seen you lose your cool, seen you talk poorly of another. Like, I've watched my correct formation, what to hold with others and how to expect different and create different. And it has been the greatest freedom of my life to not let that stuff into any core of my being ever again. That's the correct formation of how to handle life. There's no way you guys could scale at the level you do without complete control of your mind in that way. It's one of the greatest things I learned from you guys.
Yep, I was just saying that. It's like, I don't know how you can break it up into parts, but if you could, I think it's two part mental, one part mechanical. I just feel like the mental game is so senior to the mechanics. It's senior to the mechanics, and how to keep yourself mentally in the right space over and over and over again, you know, with what you're bombarded with in life is just, you've got to surround yourself. One of the big important things that we do, A, with the right information, B, with the right community, with the right group of people who are actively interested in the success of you, who are supporting you, who are supporting themselves, who are showing up to events, who are learning themselves, who are constantly like pushing themselves to the next level, you know, who don't settle for mediocre and complacency and when's enough and when are you going to be okay and when are you going to enjoy life? It's like, what are you talking about? Like, this is enjoying life. I'm like, going, I have the audacity to go for my goals and my dreams every single day, whether I'm kicked in the gut or falling down or hitting with a failure or a no, it's all good. I love it all. I'm going for it. I'm like,
that's right.
Over the fields, you know?
Right? If only everyone looked at all the challenges of life, like, here we go. Let's do this. This is what I was made for. Like, how different the world would be. I'm like, man, I eat challenge for breakfast. Let's go. It's what makes the world go round. I love it too.
Well, you're amazing. I'm going to let you go. Do you want to say any little parting words?
Yes.
I'm so happy you've spent 30 minutes with me. Thank you.
Thank you for doing this. Thank you for serving people like this. This is absolutely amazing. I will say this last thing. Every single one of you who pops on here now or on the replay, what Elena is offering to you for the last day today, I would pray for opportunities like that. I would be like, I'm down to my last. How do I change? How do I grow? The moment you invest in yourself and you learn these tools, I've learned a lot from a lot of people and how Elena breaks down life, business, rules, protection of your mind, your empire, your heart, your relationships. I have learned more in this time than anything. And I will say this will be your best purchase of your summer, the absolute best, maybe the year, maybe your life, but conversations with this woman have absolutely changed my life. So Elena, I want to make sure you guys see that pinned link right there. And not only that, it's great to grow. It's terrible to grow alone. So I want you to reach one other person. I want you them to take the course with you. You guys both get it. Talk about it. You hold each other accountable, and we'll see you at the next Empire Builder event, because I will no doubt be there. I love
you. Oh, yay. I can't wait to see you again. August 19th and 20th will be a person. You're the best. You're the best. Thanks for being on my team. You know I got your back, too.
That's right. Always back to back. Love you, Elena.
Love you, woman. Bye.
Bye.
So Heather just said, where do I purchase? I pinned the link. If you go to elenacardone.com/July, that should hit you to the special. It's your birthday, Sarah. Happy birthday. Yay. Danelle, I'm going to see if Miss Haiti wants to come on up. This is, let me find it. Hold on. Pin, comment, report, add, remove, go live. Yes. Okay. This is Hermani. I brought you up last week, I think, or the week before that. Hey, Hermani!
Hi! How are you doing?
I'm so good. I just got back into Miami. My hair, like, no joke, since I've been on this Instagram, has just completely frizzed from the humidity here. There goes the blowout, but you know what? It's okay, because I'm in Florida.
You look beautiful. Listen, it's not the hair, it's the spirit. It's your heart. It's the way you serve other people.
It's a lioness. I'm the lioness now.
It's beautiful. So what I would like to tell the people, you know, I went to school to be an engineer, and there are so much things that you learn when you start going to conferences, when you start going to mastermind like yourself. I attend your mastermind, and I was like mind-blowing, right? And I always ask, what is the formula to success? Why? Everybody gonna give you a different formula to success.
I can give you the number one rule to success.
Go ahead.
Want it?
And I'm waiting.
Okay, the number one rule to success, and I cannot take credit for this. I learned this from Greg Cardone, my biggest mentor, right? The number one rule to success is always show up. Always show up. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, and which that gonna, I wrote it down in my note, which gonna tie to what I was gonna say. So going up spiritual, people be like, I have faith. So if I ask everybody here, any of you, do you have faith? If you have faith, drop a number one. If you have faith, just drop a number one. If you have faith in your spiritual life, in anything you're doing, just drop a number one. And when I learned the formula about success, it was mind-blowing. And what you just said just confirmed what I'm about to say. Because most of us will say, oh, yeah, I have faith. Okay. If you have faith, you got to take action. Because faith don't go alone, right? So when you say faith, you're also talking about focus. You're also talking about effort. So it's a triangle. in order for you to have faith, you gotta have focus and effort, right? It's like a team. So most people will say, I have faith, but they won't take action. I have faith, but they don't have focus. I have faith, but no effort. So if you really want the formula to success, you have to take focus, time faith, time effort. So for example, if you say, I'm going to post like 5 posts a day for a week, that's about 25 posts. But for that week, you end up posting one time. So now it's showing you that your focus wasn't 100%. Hi, Uncle G. So your focus wasn't 100%, right? So now even when you give 95% of your focus, of your faith, of your effort, your success level, it's only at 85%. So when people say, I have faith, but they won't take action, to me, it's saying that there is no faith. Faith do not exist without effort or focus. So for me, this is what I'm going to do for everybody watching. For those of you that's about that life, that say, I have faith. I want a better life. I love Elena. Because saying you love Elena do not change your life. It's what action are you taking to work in yourself. You already have all the information. Therefore, she already learned it, but she want to give it to us. I mean, like, you say $270? Like, people can actually buy your course for $270, guys. $270. So here's what we're going to do. For those of you that really say you have faith, I'm going to give you a chance to click on elenacardone.com/July. As soon as you purchase your ticket, I want you to type your receipt number, because what I'm going to do, I'm going to add another ticket for some people. So instead of you having one ticket, it's going to be 2 tickets, because I'm going to buy an extra one for you to either have it with, for your daughter, your son, your cousin, your friend, because no woman left behind. But we understand that people that do not take actions can't go nowhere. And also we know, like, free people don't get nowhere. Like, you can just want free things. When you don't pay for nothing, you don't show. When you pay attention. So for those of you that really say, I want my life to change. I want to help. I wanna build a legacy for my family. I want to leave something for my children. Okay, we're going to stop talking and we're going to start taking action. And I'm going to help you. So when you go up here and you click on elenacardone.com/July, get your ticket, just tap there on your receipt, and we're going to pick some winners. I don't even care how many we pick. But I want to help you to show you that those information going to change your life. Those information changed my life. So many things I learned from the mastermind. Listen, I never heard learn that in college. And I have a whole doctorate, and I did not learn those things. Because if you really want to build your empire, you're going to have to go back to the foundation. And those information are your foundation. I mean, just like yesterday, we were learning. She was literally teaching us about what wealth means, what prosperity means, what abundance means. Sometimes we say things, we think we know what they mean, and that's not what they mean. I mean, English is my 4th language, so I'm literally the person that can say, I think that's what it means, and you really don't mean that. So the fact that she's taking her time, she's going to put you in a group. We have a Facebook group. You be part of it, where she go live and really taking her time to really help you evolve and elevate. So don't say you want something and then no action. Don't say you have faith and then no focus. Don't say you have faith and then no effort. It doesn't work like that. So we're going to help. I'm personally going to help the one that take action. So if you buy your ticket, drop your receipt below, and then I'm going to get another one for you, and then you can get it to somebody. So you, your husband, because, you know, you got to make sure the whole family is getting the information.
Oh my God, you're an amazing woman. Thank you, Harmony.
You're welcome. Wow. You're welcome.
Thank you.
I love that. Way more.
Wow. Well, today's the last day. So I appreciate you doing this for me and for everybody that's going to want to take advantage of that. Thank you.
Yeah, but you know why I decided to do this is because I know that once they get the information from you, they're going to realize, like, you're not just talking. You are really about that life. Everything that you teach, you live by that. You live by the principle. You're very transparent. You really do want people to win. That's why you're trying to build an empire, to have a lot of women with you. You could not be like, hey, I'm a billionaire. I don't care. Who are you? I don't need to talk to you. But no, you're like, no, I'm going back to elevate the masses with me. I'm going to take everybody with me. Like, you're not selfish. And I want the people to know the value is really on the information. And you're going to hear her voice, like, talking to you, telling you what to do. And she will put you to work. So I'm just letting you guys know, if you really want a change in your life, if you really, I mean, if you don't want change, that's not for you. If you really want to build an empire, like you've been saying, if you really want to be like Mrs. Elena, like you've been saying, she's beautiful. She has this. She has to take action. She did not wake up one day and be like, God, give me everything. No, she did her part. And then now it's your time. And I always tell people, 2022 is your season to win. But you can't win if you don't want to do anything. God's going to do his part, but you still have to do your part. Okay?
Okay. I love it. I love it. And lastly, before I let you go, I was just going to tell you that Grant and I were talking on the plane on the way back to Miami today from Malibu. And we were saying, because I'm writing this next Build an Empire Mastermind, I'm calling it Create Your Wealth. It's the money edition, right? Money, create your wealth. And we were talking about it. And Grant says, yeah, all these people that want to be a billionaire, you want to be a billionaire, help a billion people. If you help a billion people, you'll be a billionaire. So I see that in you right now, taking action tonight. So I love you, girl. Thank you for your support.
I love you more.
Thank you.
And you can
don't you play the I love you more game with me. You won't win that one.
I love you all the way from Haiti to America. How about that? How about that part? That's like countries to countries.
Oh my God.
What I'm going to do for the people to know that I'm not just saying this, when you write your receipts, you can post it on the comment. I will send the screenshot to Mrs. Elena. So you make sure you put your receipt number, your Cash App number, or your PayPal number, whatever you have. Put it there. I'm going to take a screenshot. Once I send you the money, I'm going to send it to Mrs. Elena, and I'm going to post it on my story too, so you can see it, that I'm not just saying this, that we are about that life. So get that information and build your empire as well. Okay?
Okay. Thank you, Harmony.
I appreciate
you. You're amazing.
Bye.
You're amazing.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Okay, everybody, thank you for joining in to our live tonight. It has been amazing talking to y'all. It's so good being back on the East Coast in Miami here. My house is totally under construction, both of them. We got this bad boy lurking. Don't you love him? Anyway, take advantage of this offer, ElenaCardone.com/July. I have it posted in the pin below. You guys are amazing. Let's go build an empire, okay? Be great. Nothing else pays. And you owe it to yourself. It's your duty, your honor, and your responsibility, okay? Go fulfill some dreams. Go fulfill your dreams. Have the audacity. Have the courage to go out and be great. Make some change. Help some lives, okay? I'll see you next week, everybody. See you later.